Stairs to the basement where he sleeps. And you do it. You turn around and walk up the stairs, and you toss a few things around to make believe it was a robbery, and then you leave. It's so easy.
She said it'd be unlocked.
What?
I don't want to do this.
We should go.
Whoa,
gloves. I can't do this, Mike.
Wait, what do you mean you can't do this? We were sent here to do a job. Now, I don't know about you two, but I'm going to get paid. So both of you get your damn heads together, because we're not going to turn back.
Mrs. B?
Hi.
Have a good summer?
I missed you. How was yours?
Same old, same old. Worked.
Well, weren't you talking about going to live with your father this year?
He got himself a new wife. Let him beat on somebody else, right?
People can be so mean. Believe me, I know. Look what they did to me. She got the promotion over me. You know what to do. I read in the bulletin about your promotion. That's great.
I'm sorry I got it instead of you. I'm glad I got it.
Don't be silly. You have been a study hall monitor for much longer than I have. And it's just fair.
Oh, thanks. Well, Joe and I can really use the money. And, you know, I hated to buy a new car, but the old one just wasn't going to make it through another winter.
They egged my car.
Oh, no, those darn kids. Oh. Well,
Let me get some paper towels.
No, you right? No, you have to get home to Reuben and the family.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Well,
welcome back.
Hey, Mike. Nice ride. Where'd you get it?
It's female loan this week.
You know, you're not old enough to drive? You know Josh?
This is Mike.
Give me a lift.
I don't think so. Would you please get your hands off the chrome? Damn. Who's the fool?
Yeah. One of my many admirers.
Yeah, right.
So, where are we going?
Hi, Mom.
Hi, sweetheart. How was your first day of school?
Good. I got the same math teacher. She's hard, though.
Well, I know you can do it. Can't believe my little baby's growing up so fast.
Mom.
Well, you are my baby. My only child.
What about Chuck and Brooke?
They're Reuben's kids.
Heads up, Brooke. Can't get around. I'm on you.
Chuck!
Shoot it, Chuck. Shoot it!
Not
to her! No! Foul! Foul!
Foul!
Foul!
Why?
Girls can't play basketball.
Oh! Jesus!
Got it!
Reuben, you know, I don't ask much. I work all day.
So do I.
And when I come home, I'd like to see some dinner on the table. I think that's fair, don't you?
Sure.
Heavenly Father, we ask thy blessings on the bounty spread before us, and we ask for strength that we walk always in thy path. Amen.
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 You can leave the dishes, Reagan. You've got homework. And we don't. Chuck, what did you do with the peanut butter?
I haven't seen any peanut butter.
There was a full jar sitting right here. You stole it, didn't you?
Right. He's turned kinky.
What did you say to me, young lady? How am I supposed to make Reagan's lunch with no food? You just tell me that. There is never anything in this house. Look at this. Nothing. No bread, no milk, nothing. I get so fed up. If I don't do everything myself, nobody helps me around here, and I'm getting really fed up with it. Just so fed.
What's going on?
Nothing.
Try to be a little nicer to Diane, will you?
Sorry, Dad.
Maybe I can fix this thing.
Sorry, Dad. Like it was our fault. Why do we always do this? I mean, why don't we just tell him how she really treats us?
You know why? Because it's going to cause a fight, and then Mom will be harder on us.
Don't call her Mom. She's not our mom, and she never will be. She's not going to make things harder on me much longer, because as soon as I can get it together, Chuck, I'm out of here.
Brooke, do not make trouble.
Duh.
Please don't do that. You know I don't like that kind of stuff.
That stuff? That's great, Diane. That's just great.
Fine. Have fun.
For God's sake. You act like I want to rape you.
You want it? Here it is. Take it or leave it. Rube. Rube the boob.
Jack.
Oh, Reuben, hi.
How are you?
There. Let's get the car. Picnic, huh? Here you go, Jack.
Take care of Reuben for me here, okay, honey?
Look at this kitchen. I hope you're a magician.
Yeah.
Good. Oh, look here. I'll do that.
Thanks.
You know, it's funny we never met before. I thought I knew everybody. Such a small town. We've been here 5 years.
Well, maybe you know my wife. She runs the sweatshop. She runs the sweatshirt shop in town. It's kind of a part-time deal.
Oh, sure. Mrs. B's.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
You hold this for me?
Sure. Yes.
I saw you before.
Really?
Yeah.
When?
About 2 years ago in the park.
You remember that?
Yeah. You were pushing a little girl on a swing.
I was Mary.
It was nice. You looked, happy.
Against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen.
Good sermon, Pastor.
Thank you. Reuben, I want to thank you for your help with the girls' basketball team.
You're doing good, aren't they?
Diane, it's wonderful to see you.
And you as always. May I drop by to see you later this week? I have some ideas about the harvest dance.
Fine. Anytime.
Good. Thank you.
I can't believe it. They are both married with kids.
Oh, you mean they're not just carpooling?
Like I said, I am getting too old for this.
I don't know what I would do if my husband had an affair.
Oh, I do. I'd hire a hitman and have him killed.
Okay, well, what if we just move this wall over here?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
You could. House will fall down. But it's a load-bearing wall.
Okay. So what if then we just turn the laundry room this way? And that way, there's more space. What do you think?
That's good. That works.
Thanks. You know, I used to do a little design work here and there.
Really?
Uh-huh.
Even if I don't know a load-bearing wall when I see one. I also make a mean pumpkin pie. You want some?
I'd love some.
There you go. That's 15 and 20. Thanks very much.
Sorry.
Hey, Dad.
Hi, hon.
Yeah.
Where's your mom?
She's in back. Will you tell her that I went to lunch?
Yes.
Okay.
Diane, I just went down to get Chuck his new glasses, and they said you hadn't paid him.
That's right.
Well, I gave you the money.
Uh-huh. Reagan wanted some new shoes.
Well, new shoes weren't in this month's budget, honey. We talked about that.
Not in the budget. Not in the budget, honey. We talked about it. I am so sick of hearing that. If you only knew. Seems like there's plenty of money when your kid needs glasses. But when it comes to my kid, it's not in the budget.
Don't start that, Diane. Reagan's my kid, too, you remember? And aren't they all our kids? Now, Chucky needs those glasses.
Well, Rube, maybe... if you made more money, you could buy him some glasses all by yourself, and I wouldn't have to hold down two jobs. And maybe, for once in my life, I could get enough.
Diane, calm down, baby.
Leave me alone. What do you know about anything?
Diane.
Nope.
Don't. Don't.
Can I help you?
Hi.
Good morning.
The one.
So, what'd your husband say about the new estimate?
I'll talk to him about it later tonight. It looks painful. Do you want something for that?
No. I'm tough.
Chuck came by with the hinges yesterday.
Yeah, he told me you gave him lunch. Thank you.
He's a good kid. Taught my boy a computer game.
Yeah. You know, when Sue died, I was going to raise Chuck and Brooke by myself. And one day we went into a market. A woman walked in. Chuck just went crazy. Mommy? Mommy? I knew my kids needed a mother. Why am I telling you all this?
Hey. You can talk to me.
She's nuts, Claire. She is just nuts.
Your wife did that to you?
I knew it was a mistake the minute I married her.
But you've stayed with her.
I didn't see that I had any choice. My kids had already lost one mother. I couldn't take another away from them. Then Reagan came along. You know how I feel about my church.
They don't approve of divorce.
Not hardly. I did everything else I could think of. Marriage counseling. She went with me once. That's it. She said I was the one with the problem.
Sounds familiar. Except Jack won't even go. He says if I could just get my act together, then everything would be okay.
I didn't know that. I'm sorry.
He's a good man. He doesn't hit me or nothing like that. It's just that there's nothing there anymore.
You know, I told Jack that I would get this thing done by Thanksgiving, and I think I ought to get on with it.
Thanksgiving, I thought that it was going to take longer.
Hi, Diane. We called Brooke and told her that we were coming.
Chuck, your grandparents are here.
Reuben out in the shop?
He's with our daughter.
Hi, guys!
Hello.
Hi!
Hello.
Wow, how are you? Oh, Brooke, good to see you. I know.
If you want to entertain your grandparents, why don't you do so in your room? Thank you.
Come upstairs.
Grandpa? Missed you.
The new place is only about 3 hours away. You'll come and see us.
You know, while we were unpacking, I found something that I didn't even know that we still had.
Is this Mom?
That is your mother, Sue, while she was a senior in high school.
You know what? You should hide that, because if Mom finds it, she'll just tear it up like the others, Brooke.
You know, I don't understand it. After all these years, she's still jealous of Sue. Jealous of a dead woman.
You haven't many people over for Thanksgiving.
No, I don't know why I bought such a big turkey. You?
I'm gonna roast a pheasant. Me and my brothers go out hunting sometime, although we haven't had too much of a chance this year. Well, there you go, madam. There's a brand new kitchen.
It's beautiful.
It should be. You designed it.
Yes, yeah, sure.
If you have any trouble with this tile again, you'll call me, huh?
Right.
You know, I really enjoyed our talks together. A lot. And, gonna miss him.
Me too.
I'm sorry. that was wrong. I'm really sorry.
Reuben.
So glad you're here to help me.
I just miss seeing you every day like I used to in school.
Well, I miss you too. But you know what? I don't think of you as that little schoolgirl. Hey, look at you. You're a young woman now. You know what? I think that we should change your hair. Yeah, so they can see your pretty face in those eyes.
Yeah?
Yeah, let's see how that works. This. Take a look. There. See? Good. That's good.
No, it's not.
Oh.
Oh, you
just. Well, hello, stranger. Where you been? I was worried about you. Playing hooky again, huh?
Yeah. They're gonna kick me out if I'm absent one more time.
Who said?
Principal.
I'll talk to him. Don't sweat it.
He's mad. It's not gonna do any good.
Hey, have I ever let you down?
You're bad, Mrs. B.
Hi.
Hi. Oh. How are you?
Okay. Scared?
Yeah. And, you know, I would never have believed that I could ever love a woman again like I did Susan, but it happened. I want you. I want us to be together for the rest of our lives. I know that sounds crazy,
no,
but...
No, it's not crazy, but we have kids and husbands and wives and... And you told me you don't believe in divorce.
I believe in you. And I believe in us. As long as I know you love me.
I fell in love with you the first day I met you. Watching you work every day and wanting you and thinking if only you could be mine and telling myself I'm such an idiot. I mean, a chance meeting and I'm a basket case.
Hey. Is that a yes? You don't have to answer now. I'll wait as long as it takes, but I want to make you my wife, Claire. I know in my heart that we belong together.
Brooke, did you take my necklace?
please you, okay?
Happy holidays.
Hey, little brother.
Barb.
Thank you.
Hi, Steve.
Ruben.
Happy holidays.
Thanks, same to you.
I talked to Mom. I told her we'd have Christmas at our house. You guys coming?
I don't know what Diane wants to do. Ms. Brown, I'd like to introduce my sister, Barbara, husband Steve, Kulos. This is Claire Brown.
Hi. Ruben's told me a lot about you, about the kids.
I did her kitchen.
Good. Shall we show them how to do the real poker?
Sure.
You ready? Let's go.
Come on.
Okay. Ms. Brown.
No, Ruben, I don't know how to poker.
Well, I'm going to have to turn you into a good German.
Anymore, not to any of us. The answer is yes.
Let me get my coat first.
Oh, I think this is it.
Right, yes, that is. Thank you.
Yeah. Ruben? Are you cheating on me?
You could say that, Diane. I'm in love with somebody. I want a divorce.
It's because of the sex, isn't it? It's because I say no. I can't help it.
Be honest, Diane. We've never loved each other. Not like we should.
How can you say that?
Diane. After all this time, how many times have you ever told me that you love me?
I'm depressed, Ruben. I've tried pills, and they never work, and you don't know what it's like. Sometimes I hurt so much, I can't take it. I had this black feeling.
Diane, it's not going to work. I can't help you. I know that now. I've tried. I've tried for years, and nothing changes. I want to be happy, Diane. I want to have a life. And I want that for you, too. But it's not going to happen between us. It's over.
How do you think you're gonna do this to me? You think that you could do this to me? Get out of my bedroom, out of my house.
Hey, this is my house too, Diane.
Oh, we'll see about that, you little piece of slime. I'll tell you what. When I finish with you, you're gonna wish you were dead. Hey, go ahead. Go ahead and sleep with your filthy whore.
tell you?
Nothing.
Is that about everything, kids?
Just about.
Well, maybe one of these days I'll knock some paneling around here.
Hey, Dad, you gonna tell us what's going on? Mom's not speaking to anyone. You're moving all your stuff down here.
Kids, this is where I'm gonna be sleeping from now on. You know, for so long, I've been really lost. Ever since your mom died. But I want things to be different around here. And they're gonna be. Because I met a woman I really love. And Diane and I are gonna get a divorce.
Oh Daddy!
Getting a divorce?
Yeah.
When are we gonna live here
still? I mean, we'll still get to live with you, right?
Well, of course she'll live with me.
Oh, dear.
Who is she? Who is she?
Her name is Claire. And
Mrs. Brown?
Yeah. I thought you guys were gonna be upset.
Like, hello?
Dad, Mom has never...
What?
Just say it, Chuck.
Come on.
She hates us.
No, she's... Diane is hard on me, I know, but...
She has always treated us the exact same way she's treated you. Yelling. Beating on us. She hides it from you. Twists things. She's good at it.
All the time.
So dear.
Listen, I think maybe you all better sit down because you're giving me, you know, trouble with.
Can't you just talk to me?
My husband wants a divorce. He's found this new girlfriend. And he's turning like he's against me.
He's just gonna leave you for another woman? Mrs. B, what do you want me to do?
You know what it's like, don't you? It's like when your dad walked out on your mom and you. He got married again, right? Hey. I don't care. Let him go. Hey, let him whack her around.
He hits you?
What?
that he wouldn't. If he knew I had you.
I should never have stayed with Diane, but the way I was raised, you hang in there and you do the best you can, especially when there's kids.
And Mrs. Brown's also prepared to leave her marriage?
The way I hear it, Claire's husband has been real decent about it. Look, I'm not proud of having busted up two marriages here. But meeting Claire showed me just how miserable I was. I can't live that way anymore. And Claire and I think we can make a better life for our kids if we're happy.
I've been there myself, Reuben, and I know what it's like to finally find the right woman.
Yeah.
What I don't know is why you selected me to represent you.
Because you're the best, and it's going to take that to deal with Diane.
I don't scare easily.
You don't know her.
Eat those fries, hippie boy.
What we ought to do is beat the living crap out of this guy, no question.
Yeah, right. Keep talking, big man.
Come on. I mean, Mrs. B's the only one in the whole school who we can trust. Besides, any man who beats on a woman deserves whatever he gets, huh?
Especially a woman like that. Okay, guys. I got it all wired. Elgin and me are gonna take pictures of him with the girlfriend, like doing it and stuff.
Bloomer, the big detective. What are you gonna do?
Scare him to death with the flashbulb?
Shut up, man. Mrs. B said it would help her get some money out of him in the divorce.
Yeah, man, she thinks it's a great idea. She gave me this chick's name, description, license number. She's even gonna buy us a camera.
You guys are so lame. Come on, I mean, all we have to do is just mess the guy out. That's it.
Doug's right. Guys. What's up, Chuck?
Hey.
Hey, Chuck.
Hi.
It's okay. There's nobody here.
It's beautiful.
Yeah, I had a couple buddies who used to come out on weekends and help me when Sue was alive. It's not quite finished, but houses never are.
This is you.
Close your eyes.
Why?
Close your eyes.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, Reuben, that's gorgeous.
You're gorgeous. And this beautiful body of yours ought to be decorated.
Yeah, look at him. He took her to my house. My very own house. They're all like, I was beaten. I was raped when I was 13. Oh, God, they're such animals. So why shouldn't Reuben be the same? I want him dead, Shannon. Oh, do I want him dead.
I'm out of here, Manny. See you in 1994. Mrs. B. So, what's up?
I missed you. I haven't seen you all Christmas vacation.
So you want me to drive your car?
Well, you said that you love my car, so I thought maybe we could just take a little ride. Unless you can't. I mean, I do realize that this is New Year's Eve, and you probably have a date.
No. Just going out with the guys.
Oh, come on.
But I've seen the way that the girls look at you.
Yeah, right.
Oh, yeah? You don't think that I notice things like that?
So, where are we going? I would do anything for a set of wheels like this.
Maybe I'll give it to you.
Yeah, right.
Let's see what you can do.
Hey, there's your speed. Come on.
Yeah.
Whoa. What? Get that pony here. Wow, it's a nice place.
But lonely. You don't know what it's like, Doug. I'm alone every night. He's always with her, doing the things that he used to do with me. You know what I mean. You can't understand. Because you'd never treat a lady the way he's treated me. Just throw her away. I have this friend. Oh, she's so mad at Reuben. She told me that she's gonna find someone to shoot him for me. And I told her that I wanted Reuben killed, it would have to be someone that I really trusted. Someone like you. Come inside.
So, Reuben is proposing to grant the t-shirt store to you free and clear. But he's also claiming full title to the Bear Hole Road property.
He's trying to get the house?
He built the house. His place of business is there, his workshop. Whereas by retaining the store, you continue to have a place of business from which to derive income. It's not that bad, Diane.
Oh, really?
Defense! Defense, guard your man! Bring it down. Veronica, pass. To Reagan.
She's wide open.
Good one, Reagan. Good one.
I love him. And I'm afraid for his soul. It seems that he has forgotten every teaching of the church.
You can tell me whatever you need to, Diane.
He abuses me in front of the children. He wants to take away their home. And he just flaunts that woman in front of them.
Okay, shoot, Reagan.
Shoot! Hands up, Christy. Come on.
Reagan, shoot.
Come on, go for
Reagan,
it.
Reagan, shoot it. Shoot it.
Shut up, you bastard. Shoot.
Man.
Been telling me about your situation. Reuben, I want you to think very carefully about what you're doing. Marriage is a sacred trust. Diane still loves you very much, and she'll forgive you. It's not too late for reconciliation.
I can't do that. I won't do that.
Reuben, we've been friends for a long time. And you've done such good work for the church over the years. You know adultery is against our laws. Unless you give up this affair, your standing in the church is in danger.
This is not an affair. Claire and I are going to get married.
You see? She's driven him crazy.
Stop it, Diane. I don't want to hurt your feelings. But you can't change my mind.
Then can you at least promise me that you'll stay away from Claire until the divorce is final?
How can I do that? That'd be a lie.
For God's sakes, man. Don't make me cut you off from the church.
If I lie, Pastor, I cut myself off from God.
Then you will no longer be permitted to take communion in this church. Furthermore, I consider your presence among our young people to be morally detrimental. So we'll be looking for a new basketball coach.
This is B!
Hey!
Happy New Year!
Well, Happy New Year to you.
This is B. Miss B?
What do you guys think about that? What's going on? Stop. What happened?
Can you
just jump down
from the
rocks?
Was
it on the vacation?
Yeah. So you spoke to Diane's lawyer?
She'll get Reagan. You haven't got a prayer there.
Yeah, but I get visitation rights, right?
We'll cross that bridge later. Brooke is of age, of course, but Diane's also trying to gain custody of Chuck.
She's not Chuck's mother.
She seems to think she is. Says Chuck wants to live with her. Claims she's his emotional parent.
Emotional parent? What the hell is that supposed to mean?
Hey, all it means is they're pulling out every trick in the book to try and get that house away from you.
She's not going to get away with that.
Reuben!
Nothing, and you know it.
Oh, yeah? You try and stop me.
Watch me.
When I get rid of all this, what do you think you have to...
You stop it! You stop it! Yeah, that is enough! Enough!
You think I can't get Chuck? You just wait until that judge hears how you and your whore had sex in my very own bed.
That's a lie, Diane.
Oh, yeah? It's a lie? Call her.
Yeah, no.
Ask her over here. In fact, I've sex in front of your children.
Oh.
Yeah. You're trying to
kill
my husband!
Come on! Come on!
Get off! Stop
please.
It!
Please! Please!
Stay
calm
down! Get off!
Stop
please.
It!
Please.
Hi, Brooke.
Dad, I'm gonna go live at Carol's house for a little while. From school. It's just for a little while. Until after the divorce. I just can't take it here anymore, Dad.
I know, honey. I'm so sorry.
I'll see you real soon.
Okay. We'll move out west someplace where she can't find us. We'll get set up. We'll start over. We'll come back and get the kids.
Reuben, you can't let her do this to you.
I don't care about the house. I'd live in a shack with you, but You're talking about giving up everything you've worked for your whole life. And the kids. Reuben, you have to fight.
Claire, I'm not going to fight anymore. I can't. She hits me again, I'm going to hit her back, and I don't know if I'm going to be able to stop.
This car is such a piece of crap.
You need a new battery.
What I need is a new car.
That's gonna happen, right?
I mean, I just bought my mom some Christmas presents, so I'm flat broke.
Well, at least you've got a new job.
Oh, man. Look, she cries all the time now.
No.
It's no wonder. You know what she told me? She caught her husband in bed with his girlfriend. I mean, this is in her own house, okay? So he hauls off, smacks her one. What else she tell you? What do you mean? Was gonna kick that guy's ass or not? Yeah, right.
In the matter of Borchardt versus Borchardt, the court finds as follows. Mrs. Borchardt is to be given full custody of her daughter, Reagan, with visitation rights to Mr. Borchardt. Mr. Borchardt is to have full custody of his son, Charles.
Daughter Brooke is of age.
As to the division of property, while the establishment known as Mrs. B's Sports Screen is presently held as marital property, Mr. Borchardt has agreed to award possession of the business to Mrs. Borchardt, who is also to have the two automobiles. Mr. Borchardt is to retain his truck. Other than these items, each party is to retain all assets brought into the marriage. Therefore, the house, the workshop, and the acreage on Bear Hole Road is to be awarded to Mr. Borchardt.
That isn't fair!
Mrs. Borchardt is to vacate the premises no later than April 15th, 1 month from today.
Oh, Ray, how does a guy say thanks, huh? I was so scared.
Oh.
I thought we were going to lose everything.
Yeah.
The guys were saying. That ain't it, though. See, I think she's talking about killing him. Yeah, she said she was gonna have somebody that she cared about, somebody that she trusted, but that he chickened out on her. And now she doesn't know who to trust. Yeah, she was, like, coming on to me and everything.
Thank you.
make yourself clever. You took them, didn't you? You gave them to her.
What?
You took them and gave them to her, didn't you?
What?
My rings. My diamond engagement ring and my wedding band. They're gone.
You probably lost them at school, Diane. You should report them to the police.
No. Maybe I'm going to report you to the police. Or maybe I'm going to take this and just cut that off. Yeah, maybe I should use this, cut it off, and give that to your precious little whore. Would you like that? So our policy does cover the rings? I see. Oh, what a relief. When can I expect the check? Good. Now, one other thing. Reuben's life insurance policy. I'm still the sole beneficiary on that, am I not? Thank you. Thank you very much. Doug?
Mrs. B?
We need to talk.
Mom's right inside.
Look, I know that you're mad at me.
I thought you were mad at me.
No. I've just been so worried. My husband is taking everything. He's taking the house, all the money, everything. I won't have any place to stay. I don't know how I'm going to support my children. There's only one answer. He's got to die.
Don't, Mrs. B. Come on, it's not right. You can't think that way.
What way? I'm going crazy. I try to talk to him and he hits me. And he keeps on hitting me again and again. Care about the kids, nothing. All he cares about is that girlfriend of his. Here. And my car? They're all I have.
For me?
Yes. I'm not going to ask you to do this for nothing.
I don't want these. I don't want anything.
You are so sweet. Please, you better keep these.
Come on, I can't do this.
You have to, because I can't. See, if I get caught, who's going to take care of my kids? My kids will have nobody in this world. I have no one to take care of them. No one to love them like I do. I know you can do it. I know you.
Yeah. Hey, Mikey.
Hey. What's going on, my man? Yeah, flipping those burgers, huh?
Of course.
Yeah, so, hey, we're still going to Milwaukee tomorrow night, right?
Can't. My folks won't let me.
What? Why'd you tell him? You seen Dougie around? He was supposed to meet me.
Mm-mm. We're gonna hook up later?
Oh, definitely.
All right.
Hey, Mike.
Hey, what's going on?
You remember Josh?
Yeah, so what's the haps? You want to help us kill someone? Yeah, man, I got nothing else to do.
I am outie.
Oh, yeah? You going somewhere?
In this bird? Like where?
You want me to wait for you?
No, I told Mike I'd meet him.
You down with this or what? The guy's a lowlife. There's no question he deserves to get wasted. I ain't got no problem with that, man. She just ain't paying me enough to see him die. For what, man? For a couple of tin rings and a raggedy-ass car? You gotta be crazy, bro.
One's a diamond?
Oh, yeah, one's a diamond. Right, you can almost see it. You gonna try to get for that?
I thought we were supposed to get some real cash out of this. I mean, this stuff's not worth nothing.
Hey, come on, Josh. I thought you were with me on this.
Sure, but killing him? For a couple bucks.
This isn't about the money. This is about helping Mrs. B, huh?
You know, if you're so hot to help this woman, why don't you just do it yourself, huh? What the hell do you need me for?
Mike, come on.
Oh, what's the matter, Dougie, baby? Is it too much action for you?
So, Jeb, what do you know about this Mrs. B, man?
What's to know? She's a teacher at school. Why?
Nothing, man. It's just Dougie wanted me to help him do something for her.
Like what?
Nothing, forget it. It'll never happen. It's not enough in it for me.
I'm in the basement. Don't come down.
Too late. I'm already down.
I told you not to come down.
What is all this?
It's my new alarm system. Looks like it works, huh?
Alarm system?
Yeah, in case Diane decides to bob at me in the middle of the night.
Not funny.
Claire, it was a joke. Those jars are good for sorting screws, honey. They're going out to my shop.
Ruben, I want you to lock that.
I will.
No, right now.
Ooh. Claire, I'm not scared of her. I mean, she's crazy, but she's not that crazy.
And I know things have been tough lately. And I just want you to know that no matter what happens, I'll always be your sister. Okay? Remember the good times, huh? Come on. Look, if you want to talk to me, if you want to come stay with me, it's okay.
What about Carol?
It's fine with Carol. Come here.
So, we're gonna go to your Aunt Barb's and Uncle Steve's for Easter? I don't know what Diane's gonna do. She won't say.
There's a sunrise service at our church, and Pastor asked me to usher.
That's great.
Yeah. Any chance that you'd go with me? Well, I know that you can't take communion, but I talked to Pastor, and he said that you're welcome to just come to church.
You asked Pastor?
Yeah, I'd really like for you to come with me.
Oh, I wouldn't miss it for anything. Hey, what do you want for Easter? I'm getting Brooke some perfume.
Well, you could get me maybe a chocolate bunny.
Damn, I gotta send the Porsche back. No, really?
No, really. I mean, I've never had a chocolate Easter bunny.
Yes, you have. When you were kids, Diane used to get you guys Easter baskets every year.
Yeah, you're right. She would get the chocolate Easter bunny, and then she would just take it away because she said the candy made me too hyper.
Oh, Claire, I'm so sorry.
I'm getting really scared, Reuben. I told you to fight back, but I was wrong. Let's get away from here. Let's get away from her.
Claire, listen to me. Honey, listen. In 2 weeks, this will all be over. She'll be out of the house and out of our lives.
Out of the house does not mean out of our lives. I think she's dangerous, Reuben. Who knows what she's going to do next?
Claire, please, listen to me. I told you. You got to trust me. I told you. I can handle her.
Because you're so tough? I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
It's almost over.
Sorry.
You're not being fair. After all I've done for you, I thought you were my friend.
I am.
Doug, I need you. I'm counting on you. I've got everything set up for tomorrow night.
Yeah, but nobody will help me.
It has to be done tomorrow night. Because if we wait until the divorce is final, I lose the house, I lose everything.
I know, but...
You don't need any help. I know you. You've got the strength to do it alone.
Can I have a hall pass, Mrs. B?
Sure. Welcome.
It's easy. It's so easy. The front door will be unlocked. You go through the door, and on your right is a gun cabinet. You open up the gun cabinet. There is a shotgun. You take the shotgun, and you walk down the stairs to the basement where he sleeps. And you do it. You turn around and walk up the stairs. Then you toss a few things around to make believe it was a robbery. That's it.
Yo, Doug, wait up. What's going on, man? What were you talking about with Mrs. B in there?
Nothing.
Come on, man.
Get lost, Tim.
Hi, honey. Abe's wife asked me to give you these.
Oh, yes. They're for the children at the church.
Yeah, they're pretty.
Pretty. Remember how Sue used to love Easter when she was a little girl?
I don't think I'll ever get over losing her.
Reagan, how are you, honey?
Mom was wondering, would it be okay if she and I came and spent Easter with you?
Easter? Well, sure, honey.
We'll be home. We'll be glad to have you. When are you coming?
Hi, Joan. It's nice talking to you. Listen, about how long will it take us to get to your place?
It's about a 3-hour trip.
Uh-huh. Well, would it be all right if we came tomorrow night?
Yeah,
Fine, sure. We got plenty of room.
But what about Reuben and Brooke and Chuck? Aren't they coming?
I can't talk about that right now, but I will explain later. Thank you so very much.
Well, that's a new one on me. She and Reagan are going to come up here and visit us for Easter.
You're kidding me.
No, just the two of them.
Why would Diane drive all the way up here when she's never even been civil to us before?
Well, when you figure out Diane, you let me know.
Guess I better put this away. She always makes a fuss about anything to do with Reuben and Sue's marriage.
It's all planned out, huh? I guess. Let me get this straight. You're gonna go in there and you're gonna off this guy with his own gun, right? What kind of gun does he have?
I don't know.
Is it loaded? What kind of ammo does he use, Dougie? Where is the ammo?
I don't know, Mike. Tell you, that's why I'm asking for your help here.
Like I told you before, Dougie, there's no money in this for me. I can't do a damn thing about it.
Mike!
Well, what a surprise.
I came to see if my order came in.
Right. The sweatshirts. Shannon, why don't you go in back there and look under vest, V-E-S-T, Doug Vest. Doug, this is Shannon.
Hi. Doug Vest.
Thank you.
I can't do it, Mrs. B. I can't.
Reuben's life insurance policy is worth $100,000, and if he dies tonight, I get $100,000, and you get $20,000 of it.
$20,000?
Yes. Now, what could you do with $20,000, Doug? Think about it. The things you could get your mother, places you could go, clothes, cars, girls, anything you want. And here's the down payment. $600. When I hear that's gonna happen. But it better be soon, because otherwise I'm just gonna have to ask somebody else, then they'll get the $20,000. And I will never, ever forgive you. Understand me?
Couldn't find that order.
Oh, that's all right. I'm expecting a delivery. Why don't you come back in an hour? Okay?
Yeah. Okay. That's what she said. 20 grand.
Oh, yeah, she said, huh? Why did she spring this up now?
I don't know, Mike.
Yeah, well, I do. Why pay if you can get it for free, right?
Why are you always trying to make her out like she's some sort of bad person? Listen, I'm offering you 10 grand. Do you want it or not?
Well, you better believe I want it. Believe that. Well, I don't understand is why are you giving me half?
Because you know what you're doing, and I don't. Okay? Besides, I'm not just doing it for the money.
What about your homie Josh over there?
He's getting 5 grand. I'm splitting my half with him, but don't tell him you're getting it.
What, am I stupid? All right, Dougie, we're gonna do this. But we're gonna do it my way. We get our own piece. Using this guy is just way too risky for me.
I just want this whole thing to be over, that's all.
What's happening?
We're on.
Oh, would you excuse me? Thank you. Would you please put these in the back?
Get caught.
Yeah, you better not. You better not rip her off either. Isn't it?
Hey, hon.
Hey, Dad.
How you doing?
Well, the cops stopped me about the muffler, and they got pretty upset when I didn't have an insurance slip.
Diane.
Yes?
Did you pay that car insurance? I gave you the money last week. The $600?
I'll do it Monday.
Did you see how she's just, like, throwing stuff in boxes? She doesn't really plan on leaving. Like, it's all for show. What's up? Dad, what's with all this money?
It's my stash. This is important. There's $6,000 in there, right? I've been squirreling it away over the years for an emergency. This is for you and Chuck, in case anything should ever happen to me. But you're the only one that knows about it.
Well, what do you mean in case something should ever happen to you?
Don't you worry about it. What I mean is someday you might have to put your hands on some cash in a hurry. Nothing's gonna happen to me.
Some help.
All right.
Thank you.
I'm moving some things out today. You'll be glad to know. Could you please help me put this in the car?
That sewing machine belonged to Sue.
Sue is dead, Reuben. So I guess she doesn't sew much anymore.
I'm saving that for Brooke.
Well, I'm selling it.
No. I need the money for Reagan, you cheap bastard!
I'm not gonna fight with you, Diane.
Oh, you wanna hurt me, don't you? You wanna fight with me? Come on!
Come here. Now, I mean it. Get in the car. Now. Bugsy! Now! Bugsy!
This dog never obeys me.
Yeah. Neurotic dog!
Mr. Borchardt.
Yeah?
I'm Detective Burson.
How do you do? What's this all about?
What this is all about is that your wife here has filed a battery complaint against you.
Against me?
Did you hit your wife this morning, Mr. Borchardt?
No. I didn't hit my wife this morning. I didn't hit my wife any morning.
Look at this.
You know, she's got it backwards. She hit me, and I grabbed her arm to try to stop her.
Liar.
All right, look. I mean, whatever happened, I think it would be a good idea if we had a little cooling off period. Is it at all possible that either one of you could leave the house for a couple of days?
I'm not leaving my house.
Well, then I guess that I'm the one that has to go, since it is his house. I'll just take Reagan, and then we'll go away somewhere for the weekend.
Good, fine. Whatever, and then we'll see what Monday brings.
Reuben, wait. Please. Honey.
Look at that. They're making up.
Yeah.
Marriage.
You're dead.
Ain't love grand.
I go shopping for some new curtains for your room and a matching bedspread. I think it's just wonderful how we can have this place all to ourselves.
Here's 20 bucks. The gas? Thanks a lot. It's not like my car would make it to Milwaukee.
Nah, that's cool. So what are we going to Milwaukee for anyway?
No biggie. Just pick something up.
Anyone got pot?
Forget it, man. You can't do something like this if you're high.
Something like what?
I never give you enough ketchup with these things.
She took Bugsy. Well, why did she take Bugsy? She hates that poor dog.
Where is the ketchup?
Oh, ketchup.
Dad, when Claire moves in, where are her kids gonna sleep? In Reagan's room? Dad.
Sorry. What's that, Chuck?
You okay?
Yeah. Ketchup.
Okay. Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Oh, thanks for having us.
Hello, Reagan. How are you, dear?
Oh, thank you. Oh, dear. I didn't know where else to go, and when the police told me that I should stay away from Reuben for a while until he cooled off,
I knew that his family wouldn't want me, of course.
The police? What happened?
Reuben beat me up.
So, okay?
Yup.
What's in the bag?
Shotgun?
Yeah, right. It's not even hunting season yet.
This for me.
What time does the movie start?
9:10. We'll make it.
I want you to promise me something.
Amen.
If something should ever happen to me, that you'd find somebody else and you'd be happy.
Reuben, what has she done to us?
She's not even here. She'll be gone all weekend. I love you, Claire. I'll always love you. I want you to know that.
I do. I love you, too.
Surprised. I never thought Reuben would hit you. He was never like that with our Sue.
He'd like to see me dead. Oh, Diane, you can't think that.
Oh, yes. It's because of Claire.
He doesn't love her. Not really. He only thinks he does because she looks so much like Sue.
Just straightening up. How's the movie?
Oh, so boring.
Which means I loved it. Mm-hmm. So Chuck tells me you guys are going to sunrise service in the morning.
Yeah, aren't you?
No. Sorry. I gotta take Carol to the airport. She leaves really early. Mm. I'll see you tomorrow at Aunt Barb's, okay?
Yeah. Happy Easter. I love you too, baby. Father, as we're strangers and pilgrims on this earth, help us prepare for the world to come. And when our last hour has come, please support us by thy power and receive us in thine everlasting kingdom through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Savior. Amen. Amen. It's late. You gonna be able to get up for sunrise?
Yeah, I got my alarm set already.
Okay.
Good night, babe.
See you in the morning.
Thank you.
This is messed up. Let's go.
Wait a minute. What the hell are you talking about? We were sending you to do a job. And I don't know about you two, but I'm gonna get paid, damn it.
Defend us from all harm and danger of body and soul.
Dad?
Chuck. Chuck!
Dad? Dad! Oh my God, Dad! Dad! Oh! Dad!
Oh, two guys.
What guy did this?
Shot me. Oh. Call 911. Call 911.
I can't hear you. Slow down.
Afraid that they're gonna come after you.
What? Oh my! No, call an ambulance. Call an ambulance, Chuck.
I did.
Chuck,
hold on, Claire. Claire, my dad wants to talk to you. Hold on. The phone's not gonna reach Dad.
Chuck.
Oh. Chuck, are you there?
Oh my Dad. Oh.
Chuck, are you there?
Claire. Claire, take care of my children.
I love you, Reuben.
Claire, I love you forever.
Oh, Dad! Dad!
Speaking. Hello? Hello?
How is he?
Medical console 561.
He's dead.
Medical console 561, please.
No, he's not. He's not dead. I just talked to him on the phone.
Listen to me. Stay cool. Keep your mouth shut. Don't say nothing to nobody. You two got that?
Husband. We shot him, man.
Good morning.
Good
Good morning.
Good morning.
Well, we better get dressed for church.
I think I'll get a cup of coffee.
Reagan and I have decided to go to the mid-morning service, if it's okay with you guys.
Hello. Brooke, what's the matter, honey?
Oh, my God.
No. They're both here. Diane and Reagan are both here. I thought you knew. Honey. All right, later. I'll call you later. At Barb's.
What? Diane. There's been an accident. Robin's been shot.
There's no evidence against you. They can't prove anything.
She did it, Grandma. I know it was her.
Oh, Brooke.
Diane wasn't even there.
Right. Why do you think that is?
No, Brooke. Don't you say something you could regret for the rest of your life.
She did it, Grandma. She did it.
She didn't even ask how Reuben was killed, who shot him, nothing.
Yeah, what was that about Reagan saying they have nothing on Diane? Okay. I have to call my lawyer.
I'm Detective Burstyn. This is Detective Pike. I know this is a hard time for you, but we need to ask you some questions.
Thank you all for coming. As soon as Mrs. Borchardt arrives, we can discuss the will as well as plans for the funeral.
I just talked to Grandma and Grandpa. They said that she left with Reagan this morning. She should have been here hours ago.
Where is she? Oh, I'm interrupting your Easter Sunday.
I'm so sorry, Diane. I don't know what to say. This has got to be terrible for you.
It is terrible. But I felt that I should get some things settled right away for the sake of the children. Now, as I understand it, I am still the sole beneficiary of Reuben's life insurance policy, correct?
That's right. He wouldn't have been able to change it until the divorce had become final.
And there won't be any problem with his will. I mean, because he was murdered. Will there?
Where's Mrs. Borchardt? I thought her lawyer was bringing her in today.
Well, there's been a little change of plans. She's not coming in. She wants us to fax her a list of questions.
Fax her?
Yeah, fax her.
We ain't though, huh? I mean, he can't force her. Her own family has it in her heart.
Well, where is she?
Staying at some friend's house.
Okay, so Friday she comes in here crying that her husband beat her up. Except for the fact that he's the one with the split lip. By Sunday, he's shot full of holes and she won't talk to us. Now, what does that give you?
An obvious suspect. See, the problem is we don't have anything to arrest her on. And she's got an alibi.
I don't care what she's got. She had something to do with this and I know it.
And authorities today are continuing to search the scene. Detectives have been interviewing family members in an attempt to determine what happened leading up to the shooting. But Borchardt's wife, Diane, remains in seclusion and has refused to speak to the police.
Diane's lawyer on the phone. He wants to meet with all of us over at his office.
Now? Before the funeral? What about?
I guess we'll find out when we get there.
Maybe she wants to confess. Oh, my children.
They are not your children, Diane. They are Reuben's children.
You're all against me, aren't you? Yeah, every single one of you. Look at this. You didn't mention me one time in Reuben's obituary. Susan's name was there, but not mine.
Did you ever think to ask me how I would want my husband buried?
It's like I don't exist. I'm here.
Well, what do you expect? We couldn't even find you.
We're prepared to file a temporary restraining order, take possession of the body, and sue the funeral home for proceeding without consulting Mrs. Borchardt.
No, you're not. Don't be ridiculous.
First, you kill my father, and now this?
People, please. There's been enough tragedy.
Brooke, I know you didn't mean to say such bitter words to your mother.
She's not my mother.
Oh, she's very upset.
It's not her fault. Please forgive her.
I forgive you. Just stop spreading those vicious lies.
So, how'd the big meeting go? That woman is crazy.
Like a fox. She's down at the courthouse today. You want to know what she did? She filed a petition to probate the will. She wants sole possession of the property and assets immediately.
Yeah, before the family gets wise.
Exactly.
We have to stop that. And we got to see if we can keep the insurance company from forking over that $100,000 death payment to her.
Can we do that?
Well, it'll be a fight, but otherwise Reuben's kids will be left with nothing.
It's all about the money with her, isn't it?
And control. She had Reuben and those kids under her thumb for years. Then Claire comes along and Diane's little empire starts to crumble.
So she kills Reuben to save it?
No, I'll tell you what really gets me. She knows that her son is in the house. Right? She knows that he's there with his dad. Okay, so what happens if Chuck comes down and sees the shooter? I mean, what's the shooter gonna do? And what does she care?
Coroner's report. Oh. Murder weapons 410. Shotgun.
Oh, 410?
Yeah.
Okay. That means our killer was an amateur. Probably an old guy or a kid.
Yeah, how do you get that?
Because, city boy, nobody hunts with a 410 around here anymore. And they're really cheap to buy. A pro wouldn't use one. I'd say probably a kid.
Why a kid? I mean, there's no robbery, nothing was taken.
I'll tell you one thing, though. If it was a kid,
yeah,
we're gonna have our answers real soon.
And why's that?
Kids talk.
Hey, Mike.
Up, man, you screwed up. What are you talking about?
You shut your mouth off to Tim, didn't you? Tim is not gonna talk.
No. There's only two things you have to do, Daddy. Just keep your damn mouth shut and get the money. And so far, you messed up on both.
What do you expect me to do? Go and talk to her? I gotta wait until school starts. Come on, Mike. They haven't even had the funeral yet. Just chill out.
Yeah, chill when payday comes.
As friends and family are gathering to pay their last respects to Reuben Borchardt, Borchardt was brutally murdered in his own home in the early hours of Easter morning. As of this moment, no arrests have been made.
Idea who killed your husband? Mrs. Borchardt, can you tell us why you won't speak to the police? Who do you think killed your husband? What are your feelings about Claire Brown?
Have you no
Heavenly Father, accept into thy keeping, we pray, the soul of this thy servant, Reuben Borchardt. We ask that thee take Reuben into thy loving hands with the divine mercy, forgiveness, and understanding which is thine alone. This we ask in the name of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and in the sure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life. Amen.
This has Brooke's name on it.
Brooke has filed a wrongful death suit against you to tie up Reuben's will. His lawyers put her up to it. They're looking for a way to protect the assets for the children.
Wrongful death?
She's claiming you conspired to murder Reuben.
That's a lie. She can't do that.
Well, I'm afraid she can, and the court is backing her up. I told you to talk to the police, Diane. The fact that you wouldn't places you under suspicion.
That's not fair.
Well, the point is, until this is cleared up, you can't get the proceeds of Reuben's will. You can't get title to the house. You can't sell any of the belongings, and you can't get the life insurance money.
But I need that money.
Diane, I know. Look,
I'm fighting this. Believe me.
Oh, you better be. So, Brooke did this to me, huh?
Not sleeping either.
I can't stay here, Chuck. She knows where I am. She could send someone. You think she doesn't want to kill me too?
Brooke.
Listen. Whoever killed Dad is still out there, and the cops aren't doing anything about it. I'm gonna move to Madison, Chuck, and I want you to come with me. I'll get a job, I'll get an apartment.
How am I supposed to move to Madison? I need to finish school, Brooke. I have 3 weeks left. I'm gonna stay here. I'm gonna live with Aunt Barb and Uncle Steve.
So you're just gonna go to school every day and look at her?
I'm not afraid of her, Brooke.
Neither was Daddy.
Tell you about some money that he had hidden away. Some cash for emergencies. Tell me.
No, Mom.
Claire. Do you know where you are? You're in the hospital. You were brought here because you collapsed. Claire, your husband told me about the situation. Look, I understand the pain that you must be going through, but the only way for you to get through this grief is for you to talk about it. Claire?
Mrs. B? Mrs. B?
What? We can't be seen together.
But I gotta talk to you. I need that money.
How could you be so cold?
I thought you did it for me.
I did. But it's the others. They've been bugging me.
Others? What others?
The guys that did it with me.
You didn't do it alone? Who are these people?
I don't think I should say.
And I depended on you. Isn't it enough that the police are harassing me? What if these boys talk?
They won't. They just want the money, that's all.
I can't get you any money, Doug. Don't you understand? Everything is tied up, every single penny. The insurance money, nothing.
Okay. Okay, I'm sorry.
Yeah. So am I.
Yes, I do. I have that. Thank you very much for calling.
Yeah.
Sit down. You're going to like this. That was a Mrs. Thomas on the phone. It seems that Diane Borchardt got this woman's son, Elgin, and one of his friends to take pictures of Reuben with his girlfriend. This woman called because she didn't want her son implicated in the killing.
Let's go talk to him.
I'm very sorry. If you could just get the boys and bring them out here. 15 minutes at most, I promise. Thanks very much.
Diane,
do not have to answer anything that you don't want to. Understand?
Yeah, whatever.
Okay.
So why did you take these pictures?
Oh, well, Mrs. B said it would help her with her divorce. Her husband was trying to rip her off.
She wasn't going to get nothing.
Did you know Mr. Borchardt?
Just what she told us.
Yeah, but he was a real bad dude. I mean, he beat her up and everything.
Did any of the other kids know about this?
Like, how do you mean?
Like, I mean, did Mrs. B tell anyone else about how her husband treated her? Come on, can you think of anyone who might have been so mad about this that they would have wanted to punish Mr. Borchardt?
No.
How about Mrs. B herself? I mean, he's ripping her off, seeing his girlfriend. Think Mrs. B could have shot him?
No way!
Well, she's a real cookie, this Mrs. B. Tells the kids all their personal problems, gets them to do things for her. Maybe gets one of them to kill for her.
Yeah, but not Corey and Elgin.
Nah. I don't see it. We'll keep an eye on them just the same. I told you it would be the kids.
Uh-huh. You also said kids talk. You couldn't get information out of those two with a stick of dynamite.
The night is young, my friend.
Yeah, like, whatever. Right, dude?
I didn't know what to say. I mean, the thing is, I think she did do it.
Look, man, even if she did do it, who do you think's gonna write her out to the cops?
Hey, I thought you guys would be in jail by now.
Yeah, I heard you did it.
Who told you that?
It's all over school.
That's whacked!
Whatever you say, Trigger Man.
What are you gonna do?
About what?
Are we just supposed to forget about it, or?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Diane, I was there on Saturday. I know what I heard. I know what I saw.
Have I ever hurt you?
No.
Have I ever lied to you?
No.
Shannon, Saturday never happened. You didn't see anything. You did not hear anything. It never happened. Reagan, now you can go and get them priced.
All in a wad for you and your troubles. Frankly, I don't give a damn. I offed your old man for you, Mrs. B, and now it's payday.
Oh, you got all my money tied up. I can't get it.
Figure it out. I killed V once, Mrs. B. Trust me, it won't be hard to do it again.
doctor's...
Daddy loved you so much. You know, when he met you, it was like his whole life just changed. I had never seen him that happy. I could never get that close to him. Until he met you.
Your kids need you. Chuck and I need you. To help us remember Dad. And the good things. Please. Good.
Weren't for me, your father would still be alive. She wouldn't have killed him.
No. No. Without you, he wasn't really living.
There's $1,500 in this envelope. But you better keep that boy away from me.
What boy?
I don't know his name, but he said that he helped you kill Reuben. Now, this is everything I've got in the entire world, except for my rings and my cars.
Now, how am I going to sell the car? I mean, everyone knows it's yours.
Well, that's your problem, isn't it? And who asked you to involve this bastard in this anyway, huh? Didn't you have enough guts to do it yourself?
Okay. Okay, then what about the 20,000 bucks? I mean, you said that we
were told gonna get... you the lawyers will not let me have it. I'm so sorry, Doug. Please, I didn't mean to yell at you. It's just that I'm so worried about all this. I promise you that when this legal mess is all straightened out, I will pay you the rest. All right?
Okay.
Oh, I need you so much, Doug. I really need you. See, you're all I've got. And you need me too. And as long as we trust each other, we'll be all right.
Going over the assets in the Borchardt case.
Yeah?
Came across a new bank deposit for $4,500 made by Diane. You know anything about it?
Where'd she get $4,500?
You all right?
Who are you?
Nick. The boss sent me down here to help you out.
Hi, I'm Brooke.
You scared me.
Sorry.
You know, you can take a break. I'll finish up here.
I'm glad you think you're ready. But Claire, I don't want you to rush things. It's going to take a long time. You'll come see me every week and we'll work on it together. Okay?
Okay. Thank you.
Sure.
I have to spend all summer with my dad. Mom's going away with her new boyfriend.
Bye, Miss B. Have a great summer.
Bye. I bet I know how she got Corey and Elgin to kill him.
I bet she'll let them do it with her.
Sure she did.
Be sure and sign it, Trigger Man. Maybe he'll be famous.
You never know, huh?
Uh-huh.
I just want to know if you did it.
Oh, yeah, I got them all.
No, Chuck, I wouldn't do that, man. Look, all I did was take the pictures, okay?
Well, then why are you laughing? What's so funny?
What do you want me to do about it, Josh? I mean, at least we have 500 each, right?
Well, 500 ain't 5,000.
I was counting on you.
I know it.
Hey. Hey, what's up?
Nothing. You guys remember that night I took you to Milwaukee?
Yeah. Yeah, what about it?
Well, I was just wondering, whatever happened to that gun you bought?
Search me. I think Mike still got it.
You're right. You were in Honda Walk, but you blew a tire. Yeah. I don't know.
Mike. What's up? Tell me. I never see you anymore. We don't hang out. I thought you were my boy. All right, look. A few months ago, you were telling me how Doug asked you to do something for Mrs. B. And the next thing I know, Mrs. B's old man shows up dead. You didn't have anything to do with that. Did you, Mike?
What do you think?
Mike?
Hey, it wasn't like it was some big deal, okay? Just went in there and we offed the guy.
So 3 months, and we have zip.
Relax, man. Kids talk.
Hey, Brooke, there's a great band playing down at Delia's tonight. If we hurry, we can catch the last set. Brooke?
You don't know anything about me, Nick.
Well, that's because you never tell me.
You don't want to get involved. It's a mess.
Try me.
Hey, Dave.
I got plans for you.
Hey, Manny. You know you were talking like you might marry your girlfriend?
Why, you want her?
No, I was thinking maybe you'd like to buy her a ring. An engagement ring?
No.
It's got a diamond in it.
A ring, huh? How hot is this ring, Dougie?
I didn't steal it. My mom's just trying to gather a couple bucks together, and, you know, she doesn't want it since the divorce. Mm-hmm. She's got a car, too.
Yeah, well, thanks. I'd rather spend this on fun stuff like food and rent. So.
Well, if you hear of anybody, huh? I can't get us any more money. What? Come on, I'm doing the best I can.
No.
You said that today Blank, what do you want me to do? Huh? Threaten to kill her like you did? You think that'll get the money?
Double twice, son. Triple's up.
No. No. Dad. No. No. No.
No!
It's okay, baby. It's okay. I'm here. I'm gonna take care of you. Forever, if you let me. Can you marry me, Brooke?
I hope that's just trash he's burning, not evidence. Damn, we've been on this case 5 months. We're no closer to getting that woman than we ever were.
I think somewhere, somehow, somebody's gonna screw up.
Well, I'll tell you what. You let me know when, I'll make sure I clear my calendar, yeah. Okay?
Look, she's looking at us.
Oh, yeah, uh-huh.
You see, there's one nice thing about a small town.
What's that?
Not too many people killing each other. It gives us lots of time to concentrate on Mrs. B.
I don't think I can take this any longer, Shannon. I can't handle this.
No, they're not gonna get you. Don't worry.
Oh, but they know. They know. What if Doug talks? Huh? What if one of those other boys talks, huh? What if I get caught? What's gonna happen to Reagan? What's gonna happen to me?
Don't cry. Doug? It's Shannon. Yeah, you remember from Mrs. B's place. Yeah, I need to see you.
Order up! Earth to Jeb.
Yeah.
I got your fries here.
Sorry.
What's your name?
Ooh.
Dude, you're way out of it these days. I think there must be a chick.
If you knew something about your best friend, something really bad, would you tell?
Well, it depends on how bad.
What do you mean, like, go to the police? Yeah. Maybe.
Are you trying to tell me something here?
Forget it.
Seriously, what's up?
It's just a question.
Killed Reuben. Don't worry, I'm not gonna tell anybody. I wanted to know all the details.
I didn't kill anybody.
So I can put him in my suicide note.
What?
Yeah, I'm gonna write down all the details of the murder. I'm gonna say I did it myself. I'm gonna send it to the cops. And then I'm gonna jump off Lafayette Peak. I'm gonna kill myself.
Yeah, right. Okay, look, cut the crap. What are you trying to pull here?
I don't think you understand. I don't give a damn about you. And if I don't do this, you're gonna catch Diane. I can't let that happen.
You gonna help me or what?
So you told her everything, huh, Dougie? It's really, really smart. What if she doesn't go through with it, huh?
Mike!
What if she blows the whistle on us?
Mike, I told you. She's got it all figured out. She's gonna go and get the gun from the field where we dropped it and put her prints all over it.
You're off the hook.
All right, Shannon!
This girl must be crazy. And even you would do that for Mrs. B.
Shannon, what are you saying?
I know what I need to know about Reuben's murder, Diane. I can handle it.
I can't let you do this.
I have to for you. Because you have so much more to live for than I do.
Please don't do this.
I don't want anything to happen to Reagan. I don't want her to be without a mother, you know?
Oh, for God's sake, Shannon, use your head. They'll think that I put you up to Reuben's murder. And they'll get me for conspiracy. You can't do this to me. How stupid.
We're supposed to be rich by now. If I'd known how this was going to go down, I never would have done it. She just stands there laughing. She's never going to pay up.
She can't help it, Josh. I told you that.
Yeah, you told me Sheena was going to kill herself, too. Last time I saw, she looked pretty damn healthy to me. I just feel like going down telling the cops the whole thing.
Forget it, Josh. Look, they don't know any more than they did. And as long as we keep our mouth shut, they never will.
Okay, here comes the driveway, so slow down. You're gonna turn left. There you go. Good.
That was great.
Thank you.
You're gonna have this driving thing down in no time.
Thank you. You know, my dad tried to teach me, but I always got mad at him.
So how's your new school?
It's not bad. Yeah. You know, at least, they don't all know about the murder, and I don't have to look at her every day, you know?
Any cute girls? What?
There's one girl.
Tell me. Come on.
No, I can't. Come on.
Baby? You mean like a baby?
Nick, I know it's a shocker, and I'm not about to hold you to anything, okay?
Oh, so that's it. You just use me for the great-looking stud that I am and then throw me away? No way, babe. You have to marry me now. Make an honest man of me.
I'm a long way from being over my dad's death, Nick. But I want this baby.
Well, so do I. I want you. And I want our child. I'm gonna show you what a real family's all about.
I love you.
Nice one, bro.
Now we get to wash them all again.
Hey, you sick?
I don't know what to do, Jay. I can't sell out my best friend. I gotta tell somebody.
Hi, Maddie.
I got something for you. You're gonna love it.
Is anybody there? Oh, well. Okay, I think I know who killed Reuben Borchardt. I mean, I know who can tell you about it. So, could you please call me back and tell me what I should do?
He didn't leave his name.
That's it?
He didn't leave his name?
Jeez, please, that can't be happening.
You gotta be kidding me. What?
Called the wrong office.
Forget about it, man. It's some smart-ass punk. He's just messing with us, man. He's messing with us.
I swear to God, I recognize the voice. What kind of idiot calls it? Doesn't leave his name or nothing?
No.
Or what is this? The guy's brain dead.
We talked to this kid. I recognize his voice.
I don't remember.
Absolutely.
Hi. How come nobody called me back?
Doug.
What?
The police are at the door. They want to talk with you. What's this all about?
Okay, Doug, you understand that you are not under arrest and that you are free to leave at any time.
I understand that.
Good. Okay, I want to ask you some questions about the homicide of Reuben Borchardt, Mrs. B's husband. How do you feel about being interviewed concerning the homicide of Reuben Borchardt?
I don't mind at all.
Why do you think someone would want to kill Reuben Borchardt?
I don't know. She used to cry a lot in study hall. She used to cry a little, you know, about being abused and stuff. And then he was mean to her.
And do you like that? Do you like that when Mrs. B cries?
No, I don't like it when Mrs. B cries. It upsets me. But it's not my problem, right? I should stay out of her business. I should have stayed out of her business.
Who do you think may have killed Reuben Borchardt?
Shannon Johnson.
Shannon. Who?
Shannon Johnson. A lot of high school kids are saying that she might have done it.
And you think Shannon Johnson did it?
No, I don't think Shannon Johnson had anything to do with it. I think that she might know some things, but I don't think she had anything to do with it.
Right, right. Well, you better go pick up Shannon Johnson right now. You get it. So, Doug, can you think of any reason why someone would name you as a suspect?
No.
Did you ever think of killing someone, even though you didn't go through with it?
Yeah, I've thought about that before.
Did you ever think of doing a murder like this with a gun, even though you didn't go through with it?
Yeah.
What do you think should happen to a person who would kill someone in this manner?
Well, they should get whatever the punishment is for shooting someone, unless they're a minor or something, right?
Tell me why you wouldn't do something like this.
I like freedom. I like my freedom, and if someone were to admit something like this, they'd lose their freedom.
Doug, there's absolutely no doubt in my mind that you were involved in the homicide of Reuben Borchardt.
What was it I said that gave it away?
Why don't you just tell me about it?
If I tell you, what's going to happen to Mrs. B?
promise.
Shannon Jasmine, you want to question her now?
Later. We got to go pick up Diane Borchardt.
We can't go busting some public high school arresting people. We'll get her later. Let's just...
We got to do it now, Pike. Doug just confessed. He's on his way to juvenile hall. There's phones there. He can call Diane.
Let's go.
Where's Doug?
Haven't seen him. No.
Tuesday on charges that they killed a man after being offered cash, cars, and jewelry by the victim's estranged wife. In a surprise move, authorities have ordered the two juveniles, Douglas Vest and Michael Maldonado, to stand trial as adults in the slaying of Reuben Borchardt last year. Now, if convicted, Vest and Maldonado could face life in prison.
A third youth, Joshua Yonke, pleaded guilty to a lesser charge in exchange for his testimony and was given an 18-year sentence.
Now, the victim's estranged wife, Diane Borchardt, who also faces murder charges, has been free on bail since her arrest 6 months ago. Meanwhile, murder charges against Shannon Johnson have been dropped in exchange for her testimony in the upcoming trials. Perjury charges against Ms. Johnson are still pending, however.
Now, Tim, is it true that a number of kids were aware that Diane Borchardt was propositioning people to get rid of Reuben?
Yes.
And these people that she was approaching, they were students who had problems?
Yes.
Was it your impression that that's why she approached you?
Yes.
Seth, who approached you about going to Milwaukee?
Doug Vest.
Who paid you money for the gas?
Doug Vest did.
So, Mike, where were you in the early morning hours of April the 3rd?
I was at home, in bed, sleeping.
Josh, who do you believe was the planner of this homicide of Reuben Borchardt?
Diane Borchardt.
Who do you believe followed Diane's directions as far as organizing this plan to kill Reuben Borchardt?
I believe Mrs. B told Doug the plan, and then Doug related back to Mike and me. And then Doug told us, you know, what was gonna happen, when it was gonna happen, and who was gonna do what.
So in your mind, do you feel that Doug Vest was the organizer of the plan for Mrs. B?
Yeah.
Josh, if it weren't for Doug Vest, do you feel you would have been involved in the homicide of Reuben Borchardt? You saw a gunshot flash?
Yes. I saw Mr. Borchardt fall down.
What did you do then, Doug?
I kept grabbing at Michael, trying to get him to come on. He wouldn't come. We were standing at the top of the stairs. Michael reloaded the gun. I saw another gunshot.
Douglas Vest, it is the decision of this court that you be imprisoned for the remainder of your natural life. By the time you are eligible for parole, you will be older than Reuben Borchardt on the day you killed him. It is impossible, Mr. Vest, to number the victims of your crime. This time, Chuck Borchardt will read a poem which he wrote for his father.
It's hard to believe that a year has passed since you were taken away. Our loving memories of you remind us that it seems like only yesterday. Where have you gone since yesterday and left us lonely here? Today you seem so far away, who yesterday was near. No map of ours that we may use your journey can we trace. We only know you've reached your home and seen your father's face. We were going to be partners someday, but now I have to make my own way.
Mrs. Vest, Jordan Packer, Channel 12 News. What was going through your mind when you first heard this? Mrs. Vest, if you can just answer this question for me, how do you feel about this verdict?
How do you expect me to feel? He's my son, my only son. Diane Borchardt did this. And she said that if Reuben ever had an affair, she would hire a hitman and have him killed.
I trusted her, and I looked up to her. She was like a role model and a mother and a best friend. I never thought she'd hurt me. You know, I shouldn't be here answering questions. I didn't take part in the plan of Reuben's death. But if she cared so much, she would have come forth and not let me go through all of this. She would have come forward and told the truth instead of letting me sit in jail.
What is the truth?
She was involved with killing Reuben.
Where were you when Diane asked you to get rid of her husband?
In school. In the study hall.
How many times did she ask you to get rid of her husband?
3 or 4.
What was your plan to get rid of Mr. Borchardt?
It was suggested by Mrs. B to have him shot.
Signed by four-person juror number 8, and it is dated today. It reads, we the jury do hereby find Diane K. Borchardt guilty of first-degree homicide.
Did the defendant equivocally hire Douglas Vest? The jury's answer is yes. Did the defendant permit the crime of possessing a dangerous weapon? The jury's answer is yes.
Do any of your jurors disagree with the court's reading of your verdict? Let the records show that no jurors indicate any objection.
How could they do this? Brooke, I just wanted to tell you how sorry I am for what my son. This is Reuben. Did you talk to him?
lovely orange jumpsuit.
We're ready now. Camera's rolling.
I don't know what I'm supposed to be learning from this. We're all supposed to learn. But I'm not sure what my lesson is. My first concern is, did Reuben have time to repent? Or is he lost forever?
Smith.
The minute I met your mom, I just knew.
1 year later, she disappeared.
John, what the hell's going on?
I've been a bad boy.
Adam Arkin, Murder on Pleasant Drive. Next on Lifetime Movie Network. The nanny, trusted like one of the family.
Don't move!
But trust turns to suspicion.
If they know anything, it's because you told them.
Does her secret protect a killer?
I wasn't lying. I just didn't tell them everything.
My Nanny's Secret premieres tonight at 8 on Lifetime Movie Network.